Welcome address to Dr. Tiago. You know, he's a good friend of mine. Dear scholars, first of all, I welcome you all to this wonderful webinar on Learn, Relearn, and Unlearn. And by Dr. Tiago, he is a reputed professor, and he is known for his technological updated knowledge, and he is known for guest lectures all over India. He is known everywhere. He is known all over the, he's a known person all over India. And immediately after posting his flyer in my Facebook, I got a lot of from all sides. He is a known figure, and I hope he will achieve greater heights in his career in future too, since he is in a central university. In future, he may go up to the rank of UGC chairman. I wish him all the best. In future, you are eligible to even become UGC chairman after your service. And I wish many more success for you. And I thought of having him in this center long back. But due to other some reasons, we couldn't bring him here. And at last, we got a nice person to share his views in this center. The center is so proud that Dr. Tiago is coming and delivering a lecture. I am also very proud that Dr. Tiago is coming and has accepted my invitation and has offered to give a lecture in this platform. And the university, the Tamil Nadu Teachers Education University, also very happy to have him in our midst. And Dr. Tiago has got many, many experiences with regard to technology and with regard to research statistics and being a mathematics scholar. And he has got expertise in statistics too. And for a very long time, for more than 10 years, he's been guiding many students to get through this NET, UGC NET examination. In that way, he is an expert for this, and he is also guiding then and there for BEd students too, for their practical examination. Very often he used to give a lot of tips, his helping tendency, his attitude towards helping students is really appreciable. Before practical examination, he will come forward and give practical examination tips. Before YOS examination, he will come forward and offer and give possible questions and answers. To that extent, he loves teaching profession. To that extent, he loves helping students to achieve greater heights. In that way, when you try to help your students to achieve greater heights, God will definitely make you reach greater heights, because that is the beauty. To have this type of attitude, like teachers should have attitude like Dr. Tiago, that kind of helping tendency if we have for helping all the people to go to reach greater heights, definitely God will make you to reach greater heights. So with all your blessings, and I wish Dr. Tiago to reach greater heights in his career. And on behalf of everyone from university, on behalf of Vice Chancellor, Registrar, Controller, on my behalf as a syndicate member, I welcome Dr. Tiago to this center to deliver his lecture. I welcome Dr. Tiago. Thank you so much. Welcome, Dr. Tiago.
Now I am moving to the task which has in for me, that is called UGC NET 2021, Learn, Relearn, and Unlearn. What is learn and relearn and unlearn? So for this, I'm just giving one small image. So the learn represent, normally we are learning, no? So generally, whenever you learn new things, then we can refer some books or we are attending some of the lectures. From this, we are learning. And apparently, there is a problem with this. Unknowingly, we are learning the unwanted things or some kind of conception misunderstanding also we learn. That is the biggest problem in our end. So sometimes, we can understand the wrong concepts of the particular content. So that things we have to be totally throw away. That is called unlearn. And finally, we can strong the content aspects when you go for the practice. That is for relearn. So therefore, the learn, relearn, and unlearn is a strategy may helping to lead it further in the case of the if you need to crack the NEET examination. Just I'm moving to my the presentations one by one slide, and most of the participants I found it from the text message which you type in the chat box. Most of the participants are from the BA level, I think so, and that's why I'm going for some kind of. I'm not directly much focusing on much on the news in it. Just I'm going to some of the brief note about the examinations and then how you are perceiving the higher education. Just for motivation purpose, I'm showing some of the hints to you. After that, I'm moving to my presentations deeply about the content which I'm taking consideration. See the case how the people are writing the examinations. Even while you're seeing the question paper during the examinations, now unfortunately, the last 1 year we don't have the much examination because everything, even they organize the examination also, it's an open book examination. Therefore, the people's not what is understood the importance of the examination. But in the case of the this kind of examination like NTA based, some of the examination like NEET and the NET and other examinations may comes in the future. Because even the 2 days before the central government announced that there is no examination for the 12th standard for the CBC students. So even a lot of people are opposing, fairly some people are accepting the things. But the problem with this, still the students having some kind of fear whenever they hear the sound of the examinations. Because the exam is a term, particularly in the students' community, it creates some kind of fear as well as some kind of stress to them. So that is why they're not ready to go for any kind of or attempting any kind of examinations because of the what is the regular mode of examination. And the examination is much focused on the mark based, not on the competence based. That is a bigger challenge in the case of the our higher education system. Even for the school level also, they are much focusing on the higher mark based. That's why recently when I attend some of the programs, I could found that most of the education people are talking about the education system is purely based on the mark based, not for the competence based. That is a bigger challenge in the case of the higher education system as well as the school education systems. Yes, next. You can see the word studying, because for reaching the higher positions, we should be study properly. In the case of studying, the word, the studying itself, there is a called dying. Because some people are up to the dying. So when you're going to what is the face the death, up to that, the people are studying. Therefore, we are use the term is adult education or lifelong education. So education should be a lifelong, not we have to be stopped after getting the jobs. And so the education should be goes up to our the last breath. And the people, they have the what is that, whenever they open the books, particularly the young community like you, whenever they open the book, immediately they may get some kind of sleep. So therefore, we can treat it as here the tablet for getting the sleep is nothing but studying or seeing any text materials. So see, one small child, when she took the books or the mobile phone, particularly in the case of the studying materials, while using the mobile phone, automatically it comes to these, the mind automatically leads to the some tiredness, and finally they may go for the sleep. And see these things I already highlight. So for cracking the NET examinations, we have to do the two things. One is for learning and practicing. So these two things should be like a cycle. So you have to learn, then you can go for practicing. Then after that, you can go once again for learning, then practice. Like this, it should be going with the two hops like in a life cycle, like a cycle based. So some people, what they're doing, they're always doing a practicing only. Some people are not going for learning. Some people are always the learning. They're having a lot of textbooks. They're always going for the learning. But they could not move to the practicing. That is the biggest problem. They could not be able to crack the examinations. So therefore, what I'm request to all the people like you, the young community like you, you should go with the both. So first you can go for learning, and parallelly you can move to the practicing. Like you can attend some of the mock tests, or you can refer or discuss with your friends related to some content about using it. And just I'm moving to brief about how the attitudes of the young generation people like you. Even in this case, a lot of BA students are there. Why I'm showing this one, it's not directly linked with my content, for motivating you to what is that, to attend the NTA sessions very active. And just I'm going to throw some of the memes to you. This means to create some kind of attractions towards the this particular presentations. That's why I'm using as a some of the means. Even while because most of the BA students, you can aware of it. Before starting any lecture, we have to use some kind of motivational image or motivational thoughts we have to share. The same things I'm going to use as a means, because means is a very powerful tool nowadays to share our idea or thoughts in a very, in some kind of comic sense or some kind of interest manner we have to share the idea. See how the university systems, from the university system, how the students are suffer. It is like a generalized thing, and here it's not representing any university system. It's like a general way they are focusing the things. So even in the lockdown periods, all the universities, they are organizing the examinations, but the problem with the student, they don't have the they not understood the concept in 100% perfect manner because of the online mode of the classroom transactions. Even though the university is organizing the examinations to the students in the open book examination, but most of the questions are reflective in the case of open book examination, but some of the units not following the reflective based examination system. But the education background people like us, we have to think about the examination of open book examination should be reflective, not in a book text based. And these are the things why I'm focusing in the sense, because now we are much involved in the online teaching and online learning. But apparently I'm going to throw some of the lighting that's called nostalgic things about the past life of the normal classrooms. So when this is the images is talking about the normal classroom, not for this kind of online classrooms, because once you look onto the back, our past life, it makes some kind of happy to us. That's why I'm showing this all means related to the old classroom scenario. When you're trying to stay awake the boring class, like if you're sitting with my class now, so you may feel like this only. You cannot tell to me directly, but you may feel like this. And the next thing, so this also may happen regularly in the case of the previous days, before 1.5 years before. What is called my reactions when my principal announced that Monday will be a holiday. Suppose the principal announced that you have the leave on Monday, immediately the students, all the students, because you are the students committee, you may think that, wow, so you are the God for me, sir. Devan sir, ningella nalla irukkanum. Like that they, when my time joined with my other voices also. Yes, the next thing, so how the students are making a cracks about the higher education. So how do you feel about the higher education? Once the kids are sitting the top, they may think about that is called higher education. So this is a means was created by the people like you only. So for the notion that this is called higher education. So please, I request all to mute. I request all to mute.
அது கூட அவளி ஐயோ நான்
ஆக்சுவலா மேடம் ப்ளீஸ் கைண்ட்லி மியூட் ஃப்ளோரி மேம் ஃப்ளோசி மேம் கைண்ட்லி மியூட் மேம் சோ தி நெக்ஸ்ட் திங் மை ரியாக்ஷன்ஸ் when the teacher send me the principal room. So it is previously happened most of the students know they are very much proud to go regularly to meet the principals. Okay, so that time they may feel that some kind of heroism may comes, no? Because that particular students may regularly meet the HOD or in the the principal. So some kind of heroism may comes that leads them to be happy. So that is the reactions in the case of that kind of students. The things, how the people are cheating in the America, how the Indian context we are cheating, but now the entire examination, open book examinations. But even though previous also some some districts or some states, they protecting this kind of things in a different mode. I hope you already having this kind of small experiences in the school days and all. And the things, my reactions, myself collecting my answer paper in front of me. So why I'm showing this one once again, you had to check the past life of 1 year before. The past life like this only. So most of the teachers, no, particularly in the BEd, while evaluating the report as well as the any answer script, the teachers may invite us to evaluate the answers directly from us. So that times your reactions may be like this only. And my reaction when my professor asked me where is the assignment. So unfortunately now the online examination, online based lecture, online examination, therefore you don't have much this kind of issues. You don't have that much of assignment worries now. But previous days, particularly in the case of the BA students, you have to submit more than 30 records. Even when I did my BA, just I'm recalling the things, I submitted nearly 30 records in the year 2004. So that times, if the teachers are asking where is your assignment, where is my record, I feel to be show like this, but I'm not able to show like this. but the students, they may think like this. That's why the attitude towards the higher education systems, the students, they may feel this kind of attitude. That's why they make this kind of, what is this means? And see, generally in the case of the examination, if the students are failed, suppose if I am failed, I may feel like this. Parallelly, my friend also failed, how he's in react. So this is the way they are very much connect to each other. And my reaction when my teacher says to submit assignments within 2 days. So this also big challenge for the all day learners like you. So immediately the students, they may feel react like this, but they cannot directly do the things. So this all the means, I hope you know who is the man, is Vadivelu, he's a famous comedian in Tamil Nadu. So his facial reactions may act for the all the, it's may good in the case of the memes creator. Because of his facial reaction, the people's having some kind of creativity idea to generate lot of memes. And during the VIVAS examinations, particularly in the PhD or in the MED level, the people's, Deepa ma'am, kindly mute please. So during the VIVAS examinations, the people's may react like this only. In the case of the B.E.D., while attending the practical examination, like then you come for the practical examination, no? So like a commission examination. That time the students may feel like this only. And our parents and teachers' reaction when we get just to pass marks. So that time how the people are reacting. So if you get the exactly the pass mark, you may give the praise to the God. You may give a lot of thanks to the God. Lot of like 100 thanks to the God. No, so that is the reactions of the student side. Then before joining the B.Ed. College or before joining Arts and Science College, it may ask for any institutions. So during the college after graduation, so how the people are reacting is also another famous comedy in Tamil Nadu. And this is normally happened to the all the students community. There is no bias in the case of higher education and school education. So all the people, they're following the same strategy only. So these are reactions the day before the examinations, what the students are doing. After all the examinations over, generally what the people are. So generally we may enjoy, no? The day before the examinations only, we move to the temple or a church or in a mosque to pray, to get the positive results. So that time we are much, cordial with this, some kind of temple or other things. And the next thing, after revelation results, even after the revelation results also, they get that same result. So that time they may feel like this, I have cut my kaspula vinayache. So all the things I lost, even I didn't get the good results. So that reactions may come. And my friend suddenly asked doubts in the class, because normally in the case of the online, previously, the teachers may scold us while the students are cut the classes. But now what they're doing, what the students are doing in the online classes, they're doing the bulk cut only. So what they're doing, they turn off the camera, they mute the audio systems, and they're doing the regular work only. So that is the biggest challenge in this case of online mode. We cannot know how many of them, even there is 100 participants in our group. I cannot be able to predict how many of them attended my lectures, because we cannot be perceived 100% manner. But in the case of the regular classroom, it's sometimes may happen to your end also. Suppose generally some of the students won't ask the questions to the classrooms, the class teachers. Suddenly, if one of your friends, no, if they ask me some questions to your friends, immediately you may feel like this. So like this. So what happened to him today? He learned something. He understood something like that. We may feel, because generally our friend is like us only, so he won't interact with the teachers and all. So this kind of reaction is in me. That's it. And this is the way the writing examination, this image may be old, because in the current situations, both the boys and girls are writing the same mode only. Because in the case of the boys, no, in the previous case I'm thinking, but the current scenario, both the boys and girls, they are not much focusing on the now is a mark. So they need research. From that only they are working. So they are not decorating much. But in the case of the previous B.Ed. examinations, most of the time the student, particularly the female students, so they may write the different color pen, and they will mark something, they will draw very good images. From this, they are getting more marks. But nowadays, even the girls also not concentrate much on the attractions. They are much focused on the content one. So in this manner, this particular image may be older. because the previous scenario is me like this, but the current scenario is not proper. And the case of my reactions in front of the parents on parent-teachers meeting, how the people are reacting. And the next thing, this also may be old image in the current scenario, it may be, may not be apt. If the boys gets 40 mark, how is reacting? If girls get 19 mark, how she is reacting? But the current scenario, both is same only. So they are not at all much focusing on the mark. So they are focusing on the result only. They are not much focusing on the their percentage. And the case, my reactions, this is normally happening in the online class also. When the professor taking the seminar in the classroom, or when the teachers may take the prolonged lectures in the online class or the offline class, generally the students' reactions, no? What the reaction is, because only that headache for you only, because we, the teachers only, they may take a prolonged lectures without knowing whether the students are attending or not in the online class. The same things happen in the classroom also, because you are turn off the camera and you are sitting in a very pleasant nature. But the teachers like us, we are sitting in a proper manner and we could not move from here and there, because the, particularly in the online classes, the teacher should be watch the camera and parallel we had to give the lectures. So we are perceiving that the camera is our students. So therefore we could not be go away from this camera. So if you're sitting 3 hours and taking the classes, the same positions we can sit and take the class. But you have the lot of freedom to go here and there to enjoy the life, but the teachers like us, we don't have that. And beginning the semester and end of the semester, how the people are perceiving the semester students. And the particular image may apt in the some other case also, like beginning the PhD or the end of the PhD, and before the marriage and after the marriage also. Because in this manner, that particular image may be apt. So you can compare with before the marriage and after the marriage also. It may apt in some cases, in some of the people's cases. And when my professors are taking seminar, when the professor may asked to take a seminar, at that time, what is the reactions? So you may have this kind of reactions only. And this has generally happened in the case of the BA student as well as the MS students, because now the BA also 2 years, the MS also 2 years. Unfortunately, after the COVID, the relatives not coming to our homes, they are not asking any questions. But the previous days, when some relatives are comes to our home, no, immediately they may ask a single question to us. Or with their parents, they may ask. Still he is studying, still he is not going for the home job. So innuma velaikku pola appingu bangla. So that times the students may get some kind of angriness, particularly in the case of the BA students and med students case. Because in the case of the other subjects or other professional life, no, they don't have much, they don't need to wait this much of year to reach the position of the as a teacher or as a teacher educator. But in the case of BA, we should wait BSc, MSc, then BA and the MEd. Suppose if you like to go to the teacher educator, after the MEd you can go for the PhD. So you can wait more than nearly 12 or 13 years you should be wait. Then only you can be able to reach the particular destination as a teacher educator. So in between, lot of people comes and criticizes. So this is the way the higher education is going on. Yes, now I am moving to directly to the using a examination pattern. Hopefully some of the people are already familiar with the pattern of examination. The first phase, I am going to highlight the examination pattern of the first paper. I hope the second paper you are already familiar with this, because the second paper is based on your subject specific. Therefore, I may focusing much on the paper one. The second, because here I think there is a heterogeneous group, so it's not a homogeneous group. Therefore, I may highlighting the things related to the neutralized grammar, not in some subject specific. Therefore, I'm much focusing on the paper one. In the case of the paper one, in the year 2019, the examination pattern, no, previously should be differ, later differ. But after 2019, December onwards, we have the 10 units, previous also 10 units, but the way of questions should be differ, right? And a lot of changes happen also now, little happen. In the case of the first unit, teaching aptitude. So there is a 10 units, each 20 units related to this specific area. Unit number one, teaching aptitude. Unit number two, research aptitude. Unit number three, comprehension. Unit number four, communication. Unit number five, mathematical reasoning. Unit number six, logical reasoning. Unit number seven, data interpretations. Unit number eight, information ICT and communication technology. Unit number nine, people and environmental topics. Unit number 10, higher education system. especially the teacher educator. So I hope most of the participants from the teacher educator are the B.Ed. level. No? For us, the first paper is easy compared to the other peoples. Why in the sense? Because already we crossed the nearly four or five areas, subject streams in the B.Ed. curriculum itself. One is called teaching aptitude, because we learned psychology, philosophy and sociology. So this is a teaching aptitude related to that area only. So how the learner's characteristics, suppose if you are going and taking the class, how we can incorporate the teaching method, which are the methods may suitable, which are the teaching methods may suitable. This kind of questions may come to the first part. In the case of the second unit, it much focus on the research methods. Particularly those who are studying the MMAT, they can know the basic research and the basic statistics. It's also may helping to them to get the success in the first paper. And the third unit is talking about the comprehensions, like they give one paragraph in English based on where they give the response. Similarly, the communication, this is also part of the education technology paper of the B.Ed. curriculum. What is the communication structure and what are the types and barriers of the communications. So those are did the B.Ed. now. For them, the first unit, second unit and fourth unit is very easy for them, because this is the topics related to the education. And the case of the fourth unit, those are blanks to the science background, it's may helping them, like mathematical reasoning. Even though most of the science background people, they are good, strong in the mathematical reasoning. And similarly, the logical reasoning also is based on the logical things. Sometimes it may comes to the word formation question or logical diagram representation questions may come. This the fourth unit and fifth unit and sixth unit, some kind of what is this? We have to read the question properly based on the way to respond, because it is related to the analytical skill. The three questions, the three part of the questions, no? The three units are fully based on the analytic. The next part is ICT. That is also part of the B.Ed. curriculum as the education technology paper. There you can discuss about the current advanced technology, like how the online class is going on, what is blended learning, what is e-learning, which are the tools may help for the online teaching, which are the tools may help for the assessment practice. So this kind of small basic questions may come to the ICT. And the ninth unit, people and environment. That is also part of the B.Ed. curriculum, that's called environmental education. And the last unit also higher education system. So those who are studying the B.Ed., they may learn parallelly with what is NCT, what is NAC, that kind of higher education base, what is the commons, what is the policy, how the administration. So this kind of basic questions may come to the higher education. Therefore, as a B.Ed. background students, for us, you may get the plenty of opportunity to get the success in the case of the first paper. Because most of the units are related to the B.Ed., like the teaching aptitude, business aptitude is related to the MMAT, like I'm talking about education, then communication topics, then information communication technology, people and environment, and higher education. So out of 10 units, the 6 units you already familiar as a B.Ed. students, as a MMAT student, as a teacher educator. Therefore, what you have to do, you have to get the highest mark in the paper one, because the highest mark in the first paper may help to clear the NET examination, because each paper is to be much important in the case of the NET. Suppose you are getting the exact pass mark in the first paper, it's not helping to success in the paper two. So therefore, whenever you're writing the first paper, kindly think that you should be get the highest mark, because that highest mark in helping to clear the next examination based on the second paper also. So always you can get the highest mark with the first paper, because as a B.A. students, you're already familiar with this. And other people, suppose if you're not blanks to the other people, you should be learn all the concepts, because for you it's not that much of familiar. And see the question pattern, that is called blueprint. There's a 10 unit, so maximum mark for the examinations for the first paper is 100 mark. It means that for each question 2 mark, therefore 50 questions. So what is that pattern they're using in the sense? For each unit, 5 questions. So like a compulsory, so they could not ask the question, 6 question in a single unit. So they already classified that in an equal preference, they given equal preference. Each topic, suppose they're taking the consideration of teaching aptitude, they may ask maximum 5 questions. Similarly, the case of the research aptitude, 5 questions. So each question is having the 2 marks, altogether SCF 100 marks, 50 questions. Now you got clear. This is the first pattern, first paper pattern. Each unit 75 questions, each question carrying the 2 marks. So this is a pattern of the first paper. And see the case of the general examination pattern of the NET examination. We have only one examination. Previously, we have the morning examination, afternoon examination, up to the 2015. Okay. So, sorry, up to the 2019. Before that, we had the 3 examinations, but now they converted to only the 2 paper 1, paper 2. Even I cleared the NET examination when they conducting the 3 paper examination. Paper 1 is the first paper. Paper 2 and paper 3 is related to subject specific. Paper 2 is related to the objective questions. Paper 3 is a subjective, like essay pattern. So this is manner only we wrote in the examination up to the 2014. But now it's totally changed. So now the entire examination should be an objective mode only. Now for you is very easy to clear because there is only 2 examinations. There is no 3 examination. And all the examination near morning itself or afternoon, because each day there is a 2 shifts. Morning shift one examination, afternoon shift is another examination. First and second paper all together is 3 hours only. So it's consist of 3 hours. Once you enter to the classroom, so once you enter to the examination hall, for example, 9:30 to 12:30 is examination time. But you have to enter the hall nearly 9 o'clock. After finishing the examination only, you are able to leave that classroom, okay, and leave this examination hall. So in this manner, you can sit the 3 hours damn sure in the examination hall. You cannot leave, sir, I have finished the examination within 1 hour. Can I leave the classroom? It's not permissible in the case of this kind of online classes, online mode examinations. You should sit 3 hours. And the first paper, first 1 hour you have to attempt the first papers. There's a 50 questions, each question having 2 marks, all to 100 marks. The second part of your examination is called paper 2. It consists of the 100 questions, 200 marks. So altogether, it's having 3 hours. It means that you have to be respond within an hour 50 questions. So they fill, they fix like this. Because we have the 60 minutes. So per hour, we have 60 minutes. For each 60 minutes, you have to attempt the 50 questions. So what it means, you have the right to attempt the each question in 1 minute and 1 minute and 1 second. Or 1 minute or 6 minutes. Okay, you can take it 6 minutes. For each question, you can attempt the 6 minutes. That like this, you can plan it. So then it's possible to finish the examinations. And each correct response 2 marks. And good things about the NET examination, there is no negative marking. So therefore, suppose even you don't know the answer of this particular question, no problem, you can select the answer in a fluke manner. Because sometimes the flukeness of answer also may help you to get the correct mark. So better, don't leave any questions, try to attempt the question, because there is no negative mark in the case of the incorrect response according to the USENET. And no marks will be given by the question answer. And then suppose you know 40 questions, you don't know the 10 question distance, don't leave the question, because even if you leave the question also, they won't give you any mark, right? Because I already mentioned that there's no negative mark. Better if you don't know the 10 questions, kindly mark any answer random based or in some kind of fluke manner. Because sometimes out of 10 responses of the fluke, it may help in 2 or 3 answers may be correct. So that 2 or 3 answers correct, it may give the 4 or 6 marks to you. So always don't leave any questions in the case of NET examination, because there is no negative examination. Sometimes the fluke also may help you to get the correct pass mark. And the mode of examination. So the examination mode is parallel based on the online. It's an online mode that is called computer-based test. So hopefully some of the people see already are familiar with the examinations. They won't give you any kind of question paper. There is no OMR sheets under, nothing. You should sit the classroom in the particular center and you have to write the examinations in online mode only. So each questions may display in your screen, both English as well as the Hindi versions. You can read in Hindi version or English version, which is more flexible for you, better for you. Then after this, you have to attend the questions, attend the answers. Even I'm going to show the outlook of the examination mode also. And this is called schedule. It's an old schedule because now they recently, 1 month before the UGC, the NTA, they postponed the examinations. still they didn't announce the forthcoming examination because of the COVID issues. That's why I'm using the old schedule. It's a 2020 schedule I'm showing here. How they you can go for the examination. I already mentioned that the examination morning one shift, afternoon one shift. And previously, before the 2019, they have the examination in the year, the old pattern I'm talking. The old pattern, the whole day, a single day, all the net examination over, all the subject, nearly 81 papers are there, 81 subjects are there. All the 81 subjects may conduct the examination in a single day. But now, they're conducting in 11 days or 15 days. So each subject in each day. So each day, each subject is a each day. So particularly if you are going for education or history or any other subjects, the particular day, all the applicant of the education or all the applicant of the history may write the examinations. So therefore, now, because now we cannot get the computer, that much a computer for the all the applied users, no? Those are applying for NET examination. For all of them, they not give you the, provide the computer for the all the people in the same day. That is why they extended the time span of the examinations nearly 12 days or 14 days. So based on the number of people that are applying. So that is the case the last years under the RBI examinations. See this case, this is a pattern. The examination timings 9:30 to 12:30 in the morning session. If you are having the afternoon session, you have the examination 2:30 to 5:30. Altogether, the examination time is 3 hours. But you should be enter the examinations with your all ticket, with your identity proof, 7:30 and 8:30. They won't allow you along with a mobile phone or nothing. You don't bring anything in your hand, okay? So except your ID card, except your hall ticket. The two things only permissible. Even you can bring your pen. Even sometimes they won't allow the pen also. They will give the pen to you while enter the room. And after finishing the examination, you have to return back the pen also. In the afternoon case, you should be enter the room, enter the examination center. This is called not in room. The center you have to enter into 12:30 to 1:30 because a lot of briefings are there. So before entering the examination, they can brief, they can check what are the things you are carrying. They will cross-check everything and they even some other examination, they have some kind of, what is the camera. They may take one photo of all of you, but the NET examination, I think they're not taking. In some cases, in some, like when I'm going for writing the examination for the MOOC examination, ARPIT. So for that, when you enter it, they may take one photo. We can sit in one bench. Automatically, that camera, that web camera may take a photo. They assign some system for us. Then that I can sit the particular system. Automatically, 9:30, the particular system, the question may be visible. Up to that, nothing is visible. So exactly 9:30, you may see the questions in the your system. So before that, you could not, even a single minute before also, you won't be able to see the question paper. And the test of commence 9:30, the test of concluding 12:30. So this will be the examination is more going. So be cautious because sometimes you may get the first shift in the morning shift or afternoon shift. And now I'm moving to the tips for cracking the USNET examination. So previously I'm briefing about the first paper only. The second paper I'm not talking because the second paper is subject specific. So you should be look onto the syllabus and then explore the things. In the case of the cracking the NET examinations, I'm giving the tips in a two different aspects. One is called during the examination. During the examination hall, what are the things you have to do? And before the examination, so the preparation times, what you have to do? What I'm going to do, I'm coming backward. So how you can write the examination, how we can prepare like this, I'm coming to the backward of the backward way of my presentations. Instead of going the normal sequence, I'm coming back to the front. So this is called final word. During the examination, what are things you have to do? And what are things you have to keep in the mind? These are things you should be keep it in the mind while writing the examination. This is it during the examination all I'm talking here. The first thing in the examinations, what you have to do, focus on your strong areas, please. Even in the first paper, there is a 50 question, as you all of you know. Out of the 50 questions, don't attempt the vague questions or not familiar with this. For example, out of 10 units, you are very much competent with the teaching competency or research aptitude or in ICT. You can go and attempt the question first to that area. Because once you concentrate the area which is not familiar, it takes much hours. It takes, it sucks your timing. Therefore, always you can start the examinations, because when you see the screen, no, automatically each screen one questions may come. When you read the question itself, you can understand in which area the questions may come. Suppose you are not strong that particular area, you can skip the question, you can move to the next area, next question. So automatically we can find the final, we can know that which are the questions we skip, which are the questions we attempt. Everything in the right corner we can see. So there is a different color they may give. Even I can show the examination view in the case of the system, so with the use of some other tool also. So always you can focus on your strong area during the examination. And even the strong area, suppose you have the strong area, suppose I am very much competent in the ICT, the particular area when I am selecting, no, there also there is a 5 question. I already mentioned that each session there is 5 questions. Out of the 5 questions, I am very much familiar with the 4 questions. So I can attempt the first 4 questions. So 1 question, it makes a lot of confusion. Don't waste the time with that single question. So you can go to the next question. So suppose if you have any confusion with the question or the options, don't spend much time the particular questions. Instead of that, you can leave the question, you can move to the next question. So this is second things here to be looked on it. Even you can select your area, but parallelly in that area, you can select and you can attempt the questions which you are familiar, right? The third things, the biggest challenge for the people, even when I read some of the questions online, no, because I'm regularly creating some mock questions, even myself also, I did some kind of blunder mistakes. Instead of reading the question fully, I can attempt the answer. But the time of seeing the result, no, I feel that the answer is wrong, because I have not read the question clearly. Because sometimes there is a small word, which of the following is not, the word is important, is not a assessment tool. Which of the tool is related to the assessment tool. So when I read the questions, I may read the question which is the tool is related to the assessment. But I'm not focusing on the word not, because when I read the questions, once you read the question fully only, whether the questions having a not or not. Suppose when I read the questions like in a scan manner, like in a single scan manner, I feel that which is the tool which is related to the assessment. Then I look onto the doubt. One tool is familiar for me. For example, there is a tool is related to Google Forms family. Then immediately I click the Google Forms correct answer. But the problem with me, because I'm not read the question, sometimes the questions with me comes like which is the tool is not, the word is important, it's not related to that. Therefore, you should be clearly read the question as well as the option fully. After read the questions only, you should be attend the questions. So don't blind on over enthusiasm or overconfident, don't attend the question, because even the questions you are very familiar, due to the lack of reading, lack of reading the full of the questions, you may attempt the wrong questions, wrong options. Therefore, better to attempt any questions, kindly read once fully, then attempt the next question. And the next important tactics in the examination hall, what you have to do, even that areas to be familiar, but don't spend much time for the lengthy question, because some questions, for example, in the case of comprehensive questions and all, there is a one paragraph, based on the one paragraph, they can ask the 5 questions. So what you have to do, you can attempt this kind of question the last. Suppose if you are spending the time for reading the passage and giving the responses, even for each question we have to read each time paragraph, then only you can find the answers. Therefore, it takes much hour. So you have to eliminate this kind of errors in the examination. Better to attempt this kind of questions in the last. So that is why I am giving the tips of set, skip the lengthy questions in the examination, the starting the examination. So you can give this kind of preference the last. Okay, the next important thing, save answer while attempting all the examinations. I think the save answers. So just I'm going to show the template of the examination. So please kindly see my screen. I'm going to show the template of the examination. How the examinations, the question paper, it may visible to you. So this is a tool I'm using that's called PaperShala. This tool, the same like the NTA examinations. Okay, so I'm already having the account as a student account. I'm going with this tool as a teacher's user. I'm going to enable this one, okay, because this tool is called PaperShala. This looks like the same, just I'm creating a small test for the demo purpose. After I'm going to do So even you can try, suppose you want to create any examinations and you want to attend the examination the same format of the use net examination, you can use this tool, it's called Paper Sala. As a teacher, you can create a one question. So even if you are the teachers, if you are the learner also, you can create some questions here. This is the teacher's view. What the teachers can do, you can go to the papers. First, you can create a papers. You can create add new paper. When you create the add new paper, I'm giving the paper as called demo net NPA exam. Like this, I'm giving the question paper name. And here, it gives the per question so 1 mark. And the examinations for 20 minutes. All the settings are already disabled. All the default is to be enabling. I'm click next step. Once I click the paper title. Okay. So the paper title is basic. The next step. So the first step, the teachers from where you can do. And the next thing, after creating the paper name, you can go with the create the questions. I'm already having some kind of default questions. So I'm having some questions here. That question I'm going to add here as the name of add questions. Here some of the questions I'm already coined. For creating the question, you can go the questions and create the questions. But here I'm going to use this question which I'm already created. First question, second question, third question, fourth question, fifth question. I'm added nearly 5 questions here. So I'm added nearly 5 questions. After this, I'm going back. So this much things the teachers can do it. After finishing this, you have to enable the questions to the student side. What you have to do, I'm going back to the dashboard. In the dashboard, there is a question, the total questions in paper on the server. Now I'm recently created the question demo net NPA. That question I'm going to activate. So this is an activation symbol. Once you activate it, you can create a username password for the students because I'm having a lot of users. See, I'm already created the usernames and password for my students. So see, this is my Ahmed Bash. I'm already created the username and password. So for this, one of the students is my mail address. So I'm going to attempt the examination from my as a student account. I'm going to sign out. I am moving to the student's account now, Tiago CUK. Yes, so in this mail ID, I'm giving my credential. I'm giving my credential after that I'm signing. So now, papers need attempt. So examination going pending. I'm going to refresh it. Yes, I'm clicking here. Still, it's not aligned on me. I'm going to come with the other mail ID because I don't know which mail ID I'm having the account. Student's mail, I'm coming with this mail account. BM2. I think this might having this. Yeah. Now see the papers need to be attempt to paper. I am attending the questions here. There is a questions now you can see. The recent question which I enabled, it comes here. So this is the way the students may attend in your end. Attempt a paper. Even if you are the teacher, I request all the teachers to create the question from here because the same template only is come the NT is organized examination. If the people click the start button, there is a mistake I did. I didn't make the timing on my end. There is a mistake in my end because the timing I had to fit properly. And this tool is very user-friendly. See, even I'm shifting from the student to teacher, teachers to student in very fast manner. But even though it's not having any issue, so for editing, I'm going for editing. So the mistakes which I did know, there is a timing. See here, there's a timing. I finished the timing also now itself. Due to that one day, it's not showing that you can fix the timing, the end day, end timing of the examination. After that, you have to submit. After that, you have to submit. Then you can crash check once again whether it's to be enabled with the use of the dashboard. Once you click the dashboard, you can check whether the questions are active. So now it's active only. Therefore, you can tell your students to attempt the examinations. As a student, they can go with the login credentials. For creating login credentials, it's very simple. Just you can create a username and password in the same account. And this account is free only. So you can create any question paper. Even this is supporting the proctored examination. Proctored examination like a camera-based examination also possible. Then you can pour 2 more questions, 5 more questions also. But I'm going to highlight how to conduct your objective questions. But the portal is same as it is here, net examination. That's why I recommend it strongly here. If you click the attempt paper, they may get the click here start paper. Now you can see this is a pattern. The question may be visible here. Please kindly see the same mode only, even the net examination, the questions visibility. But here I'm using only the English mode. But in the case of the net examination, you can get the both English as well as the Hindi, English, altogether you may get the questions. Suppose you read the question, CC Creative Commons. If you know the answer, kindly press the true. If you know the answer, then go to the next button. Please, there is a 4 button in your examination screen that is called user interface. You may see the 4 options. One is for review later. Suppose you are not familiar with this question, you can go with the review later. Suppose you are attempting wrong answer, but after that you feel that the wrong answers, I attempt wrong answer, I want to clear the response, you can clear the response and then attempt the correct response. The third answer, suppose you are very confident the answer, you can select the answer, I can go with save, next. So now the first question over, then immediately the second question. List out the types of video sources. This for the 2 mark I am typing here. I am typing as here. List out the e-resources. List out the e-resources, that video. I am typing as a video, sorry. Because I am skipping this exam very fastly due to that skipping. So like that, you have to go with the examination one by one. So the same mode, so I am already highlight the 4 options, no? One is called save, then second one is called clear the results. And parallel, if you want to know about this one, what is this? Suppose you are not familiar with this particular examination, you can skip that question also. So a lot of options providing, and each color having each representation. Suppose the green color represent the correct answer. You already saved. The red color mark not attempt the questions. Then yellow color, what is that? The yellow color. Yellow color is represent you are not having the clear answer, but you are review. You want to review the questions. Like that, you may get the 3 options. The same mode only you might get the same template. This course is whenever you want to get some kind of online experience, online examination experience, I request to go to the paper sala. Because the same kind of template only in our end. It's a very user-friendly interface only. Only the teachers can create. And the teachers can create a username and password to the students. Then finally, you can tell them to be use this particular tool. So very simple tool only. Kindly use it. Because this tool is same as it is the examination pattern. That's why I'm recommending. So, yes. I hope now you understand how we can, the questions, how it will be. The same pattern only you can go with this. I am moving to the next slide. The save answer, that's why I told. Whenever you are confident about this particular questions, kindly save this question. Okay, save and then move to the next question. Once you save, automatically moves the next question only. So these things you should be cautious. So unknowingly don't delete that answer. Kindly save each answer once you feel it's correct. And finally, suppose you are attempting nearly 40 questions, last 5 minutes, you want to attend the 10 questions, remaining 10 questions. If at the time you can read the questions, otherwise kindly attend the questions in a random based or a fluke manner. Because if you leave the question, you won't get any mark. But in the fluke, sometimes you may get some kind of mark. So always attempt the unattended question at the end of the moment. Last 10 minutes or last 5 minutes, you should be attempt all the questions. This is practice you have to do at the end. And the next thing, always you have to think about attempt the maximum question in a minimum time. This is much important. That's why when you keep into the previous steps, like the maximum question, the minimum time, what I'm spelling in the sense, what I'm highlighting here in the sense, you can attempt your well-familiar question and which is your competent area, that area you have to attempt. So when you attempt that kind of question, so generally what it come in a minimum time, you can attempt the maximum questions. So if you're keeping the strategies and always to get the more marks in the paper one, because even I am sharing my experiences, even this is a better experience for me. I attempt the NET examination nearly 12 times. The 12th time only I clear the examination. So that is the biggest challenge for me. Even I clear the examination, I am telling openly. I passed the examination 2012 December. Before that, I wrote nearly 11 times examination. So what is the bitter experience I faced? This is basically mathematics. Mathematics in the sense of generally what is the problem for me? So language is the biggest barrier there 2012. Because I'm not much good in the case of the language, even I'm not good in this language aspects. But the problem for me in the 2012, up to 2012 December, the examination having the 3 papers, paper 1, paper 2 and paper 3. Paper 3 is a essay pattern. Generally, I may gain more mark in the paper 1. So all the examinations of the paper 1, I'm getting 70 above. All the examinations of the 11 examinations, because we can see the scores through the Usenet platform. Second paper, I may get nearly 60 something only. But the third paper, I'm always failed because of the essay pattern. So due to the essay pattern, I did not clear the examination before the December 2012. Unfortunately, that year 2012 December, government informed that UC informed that the third paper also it is in objective mode. It's an objective mode because as a mathematics students, no, because I did my UG and BGS in mathematics. Generally, the mathematics students like us, we cross maximum 10 vocabularies in the English vocabulary, like if and only if, hence the proof. Let us assume that similarly, perpendicularly, this much only, because the mathematics has its own language. Mathematics people like us, we have the language is called notation, symbols, numbers. This is our language. So in the case of the normal language, in the case of English usage, we are using limited vocabulary. I'm already mentioned if and only if, hence the proof, similarly, perpendicular, lemma, maximum, if you count maximum 20. So due to that, I'm not able to write the more essay, because even the examinations also third paper, you should be content specific. You cannot be highlight what is the blah blah things. It's not be acceptable. You should be write a pinpoint answer, but I am not competent in that area. So up to that 2012 December, I'm not able to clear. That is for SWOT analysis. What I did the SWOT analysis for my site, I am strong in the case of first two paper. The weakness of my score is the third paper. Unfortunately, the government also changed. So there is a chance for me in the year 2012 December, there's a first call for in the case of the three examination objective. So the first attempt itself, the first attempt of the objective type, I clear the examinations of the USENET. Next time also I wrote the next year itself in the 2013, I attempted for the 2015, I attempted once again adult education. In a single attempt, I clear because of the objective. Therefore, as a user, as a learner, you should do this some kind of SWOT analysis. What is your strength? What is the weakness? So once you found the weakness, if you are able to avoid this weakness and you want to convert your weakness into a positive manner, it's good. So that is you should be thinkable. So for my case, for getting the results, paper one, it may influence that, because always the paper one, the three unit, no, particularly in mathematics, that's why the three units like the mathematical reasoning, logical reasoning, and data interpretation, it always giving the helpful for me, because of the basic knowledge of mathematics, generally out of 15 questions in this particular three area, I may get nearly 12 or 13 marks. Due to that only, I'm always gaining the highest percentage in the case of the first paper. The same analysis you have to do. I request all, out of 10 units, which is your competent area, which is not competent area, that area you have to be enriched. That area you have to be enriched. For example, out of 10 units, you are very much competent in the 5 area. You can consider the other 5 area and at least you can get the 50% of knowledge of the particular area. It's always safer job. And now I'm moving to the second phase, that is called the starting stage of the preparation tips of the NET examination. Previously, I'm talking about how we can attempt the examination. Now I am moving to the how to prepare the examination. That's called backward approach. I'm coming back to the front. The first important role, kindly go through the updated US syllabus. Even if I ask the people whether did you see the updated USENET syllabus, no, most of the learners, no, even they cannot know where the syllabus is available. Sometimes they ask me, sir, where is the syllabus available in the online? So these questions I'm crossing regularly. So therefore, I request the thinkers to crack the examinations, kindly visit the website called usenetonline.in. Syllabus new. So I'm sharing the end all the links to you. So this is a link for the USENET examination. So you may get the nearly 101 subjects. Now previously 81 subjects. Now there is 101 subjects. This is the syllabus of the second two paper two. The first paper is general paper. It's already available. See paper one. The other two, the second paper from 1 to the question 100. So it seems that 101 paper. For subject specific, if you need to go with the Hindi version, you can click here. If you like to get the English version, you can click here. So automatically you may get the entire version, similarly the first paper also. As your first, suppose you want to crack the examination, kindly see the entire syllabus. Suppose I like to open the education because I'm basically from education, that's why I'm clicking the education. Once you click the education, you can see the unit. So your code is 9. You can check the unit number 1. So unit number 1 having the name is called Education Studies, there is a 4 content, 4 sub area. The unit number 2, Historical Political, this was having 4 content. Learner and Learning Process, these are the 4 content. Like this, there is a 10 units. So the similar way, each unit is having 10 questions. For example, the inclusive education, they may ask the 10 questions. So you could not skip any area. All the areas to be important. You could not skip any questions, any area. If you skip that any area, damn sure you may, what is that? Wantedly, you are not like to gain 10 questions. That is why you are skipping the particular questions. So always, you should consider the entire syllabus. So that is my always the better suggest to all of you. Kindly go through the entire syllabus. That is the first stage. I hope my screen is visible. My screen is visible. 1 minute, I'm going to.
Yes, sir. Sir, no, sir, your screen is not.
Oh yeah, yes. Yeah. Someone shared. Okay. Yes, so I request all to don't share. I request all to don't share. Okay. Yes, I hope sir. Now it's visible. Is it visible now? Yes.
Yes, sir.
Yes,
okay,
sir.
Thank you. Yeah, so for preparation, the first step, the preparation stage of the use NET examination, the first step should be go through the updated slips and go through the glance, how many units are there, and prepare the unit wise. Prepare the material in unit wise and learn the things in unit wise. Don't go with absurd manner. So kindly learn by step by steps. So the first steps, you have to look on to the entire use syllabus of first paper and second paper. And second one, time management. For example, suppose if you have only 1 month time. So I'm giving one tips for you. Even within a month also, we can prepare the exams. I'm telling openly, even I am attempting 12 times examination of the NET. No, I didn't prepare in a single time. So how for my result, how I clear the examination in the sense, because I teach the content to the BA students. So even when I studying the BA MED, I didn't clear the NET examination. When I working some colleges, on private colleges, that time I am handling the class for the BA and the MED. So due to that competence, due to the that skill, it may help me to clear the NET exam, because I'm always touching with the subjects, no? So always I'm taking the philosophy paper, psychology paper, sociology paper. All the papers I'm wanting to take the classes. Due to that only, I am somewhat familiar with each paper. Somewhat familiar. I'm not 100% familiar. Somewhat familiar with each paper. That skill, it may helping to clear the NET examinations. Suppose if you have this, suppose you are working in some colleges, don't take the same area for the 5 years or 10 years. Better to change the topic per year. Every year you can use the different paper. You can handle the different paper. Because that is the way you can update your the pedagogical skill as well as the content knowledge. Always you can go with each time go with a different paper and take different paper. Due to that one day I may get the chance, and I'm giving the tips for you. Suppose you want to cover the the paper one within a 1 month, is easy. What you have to do, there's a 10 unit. Each 10 units you can divide into four. For example, unit one you can divide into four heading. Unit 2, you can divide into 4 headings. So like this, all together, 10 units, I have 40 headings. 40 headings. So 40 subtopics. So all the 10 units, I'm dividing into 40 topics. So what you'll do, per day, you can fix it per day, I can learn 4 topics. 4 topics. Alright? Even you can take it all together in a single unit. Otherwise, you can take 2 units, so 2 part of the first unit, 2 part of the second, as you like. So you can divide the 10 units in the 40 segments, 40 small subject area. Then after this, each day you can concentrate 4 content, 4 content. And the same day you can go for some kind of mock practice, mock examinations. Okay, like with some practical questions you can do. So like this, we go with the 10 days. Within the 10 days, you can go for the, you can read the entire first unit. Even you can spend maximum 2 hours per day. So if you are covered, if you are spend the 2 hours per day, within 10 days you can cover the entire syllabus of the first unit. Very simple. And other tips as I am telling here, the other tips for you, time management. That is the time management. You have to divide the timing. So for each day 4 units, so I can fix the time 5 to 7 o'clock in the evening, or 3 to 4 o'clock, or 3 to 5 o'clock in the afternoon. Like that, you can time and work with that. Okay, don't, some people, they may start very sincerely, but after they feel lazy, they could not go with it. And next thing, whenever you learn anything, please kindly clear the concepts. Don't, suppose someone's telling something, you can think yourself, like you can do some kind of meta-analysis by yourself, whether the idea which is shared by the teacher is correct or not. If you have any comments, if you have negative opinion, you can talk to him. Then only you may get some kind of clear understanding about the content. Always, you should be crystal clear in the content, because in the question paper, in the net exam, it's not a direct questions. It's like a reflective questions. So when you attend the reflective questions, you should be clear about the content. Otherwise, you cannot attend the questions, because the content should be clear. For clearing the content, suppose you want to get the contents very clear, you have to do some kind of tips. Try to make a short notes. Try to create some kind of short notes. Short notes represent, take some kind of small hints. Right? Keep handy to keep response reference note. And group discussion. So group discussion, suppose you have the nearly 5 or 6 friends of you. They all are writing the examination. Kindly go with some kind of group discussion. So why I put this image, you know, even someone's idea is kindling us. Someone's idea, someone's knowledge is kindling us. Therefore, in Tamil also there is a proverb, the same things. In the group discussion, we are gaining the 1+1=3. So generally in the case of the mathematics, 1+1=2. But in the case of the group discussion, one of my idea, one of your idea, if you are blending the two idea, I may get the third idea. So I may be able to generate the third idea. So that is called 1+1=3 in the case of group discussions. Always you can go for the group discussion in the case of the net questions discussion. And try to teach someone. So for my case, why I have success in the UseNet in the sense, because I teach someone in the class. Similarly, suppose you are the BS, you are the MS students, you don't have a space to teach. What do you have to do? You can go with your friends itself. You can go for peer teaching. For example, I am preparing the first unit. I am completing the philosophy. Other students are completing the research. So you can do the interchange. So I may teach the philosophy to him. He may teach the research to him. So like that, you can go with some kind of, what is that, teaching based. Because while studying by yourself, you are not get much idea. But when you're going to teach someone, when you're going to teach one only, you may get the clear understanding about the content. Generally, if you're learning, you could not get the clear understanding about the content. While teaching only, we may clear that, oh, because I want to teach in a proper manner to get. That's why I want to clear the content knowledge. Otherwise, I cannot lead it further, no? So always kindly teach someone in the case of the net things. And reason and self-analysis is much important. Because whenever you are learn something today, immediately you can go for some kind of mock test. From this, you can check your progress, whether you are able to get the all the questions, you are able to attend all the questions correctly. Or if you did any answers wrong, kindly think about the way of in what way you are responding like this. So what is the issues in your end? Whether the questions reading skill is wrong for you or the recognition skills is wrong for you. Like you can do some kind of self analysis, like SWOT analysis. That's why I told the word SWOT. And you can do some kind of SWOT analysis to with you. And the things, always to refer the previous question paper. I'm sharing the link on the end. This is a question paper link. If you click here, so I'm sharing this link. You may find in the plenty of question paper up to 2014. So you can get the question paper 2009 to 2014 with the UC link itself. This is a link. If you want to get the question paper of June 2014, you can click here. You can go with this question paper, right? So like this, you can always analyze the question paper of the past. If you need to get the after 2014 question paper, you can go to the NTA. UC, there you may find the plenty of question paper. So like this, you can always do some meta-analysis, because most of the questions are repeatable. In the case of UseNet, I'm telling openly, I attempted adult education question, adult education. I'm not familiar with adult education, but I attempted a single attempt in the net examination. How in the sense, I am referred nearly 5 years of question paper of the previous years of the adult. Only the things I did. So before the 1 month examination, I downloaded the question paper of the old question paper along with the answer. I'm crash checking. I didn't read any single book for the adult education. Just I'm exploring the previous question paper. So then I went for the June, and that is the examination item, the June 2015 as the adult education. That time itself, I cleared in a single attempt because of the previous question paper, observation based only, I got it. So therefore, the previous question paper is always helping you to get the highest mark as the pass mark in the, and master commonly asked questions. So that is called meta-analysis. Whenever you read the question paper itself, you can easily understand which are the questions may repeat up, which are the questions not may not be repeatable. So you should go with some kind of picture, and from this you can prepare it. And sometimes I'm always suggesting to people, instead of reading the questions, better to read the options. Because the question, for single questions, you may find out the single response only. But in the case of the four response, if you read the four response, you can find out the, you can create a four questions. Therefore, whenever you read the, in the revision based, if you want to analyze the question paper, better to analyze the options, not the questions. Because if you analyze the each option, for example, I'm analyzing one option, immediately we may think that this option, where it may be suitable. So where it's much suitable, so that I may select it. So always think like this. Read through the options. That's why I use the term study, learn from the question option instead of the questions. Generally, what the people are doing, the examination, you can read the question and then come for the option. But the revision time, when you go for the revision, don't read the question, come for the option. Instead of that, read the option and generate the four questions to you. Then finally, you can check the questions they ask. So this is the way you have to lead it further. And to take help to solve question paper online mock test, always I'm giving one link. From this, you may get plenty of the mock test solving. This is a mock test. You may get the lot of mock tests available in this link. This is my website also. Particularly, I may create for the first paper as well as second paper of the education. Those are very much interested. I can share nearly 190 mock tests. You can explore the mock test from the single site itself. And if you like to get these materials, related to the mock test answer, if you click it here, you can find out the option called materials. There you may find out the entire question paper answer script. So, for example, if you like to get this mock test, if you click it here, you can find out the question as well as the options, like answer. So, this kind of mock test or mock test repository may help you to explore much about the online examinations as well as this kind of mock test and learn from our mistakes. So, each test is over. For example, you are attending some mock test, kindly do some kind of SWOT analysis where you did the mistakes, how the mistakes happen. Suppose how I can resolve this, the mistakes. So everything you can think and then do the next attempt. So sometimes what the people are doing, you know, once they attempted, they check the mark only. They could not check, they didn't check what is the issues they made it from the end. That is a problem for them. And the only two or three slides shortly told that I may finish. Always can do attitude. What is a can do attitude in this? It's like a positive attitude. You can think that you are able to clear the next examination. So that kind of competence should have. So don't attempt the examination with a negative sense. Even I attempted the 12 times of examination, the 12th time only I clear. But all the 12th time, when I'm attending the questions, no, I have some kind of fear only. The first 11 times, because I'm not much competent in the third paper, because it's a essay type. So due to that, I don't have much competency to write the third paper. So therefore, all the 11 attempts, with the wrong attitude, I attempt the examination. Therefore, the wrong attitude, it gives the result as a negative result. But when the government announced that the third paper also is in objective, so immediately for my end, I create some kind of, it's automatically generate some kind of positive attitude. So this time, damn sure, I can clear the examination. That attitude, it comes to my mind. Then I went the examination with full confidence. I'm telling openly, I enter the classroom with full confidence. I attend the examinations. In the end, when I come out from the examination hall, I'm having the full confidence. So that confidence, how it comes in, that because of my positive attitude. So always the attitude may help to get the success. So believe yourself. So you are able to pass, because I have the experience that I'm 11 times I didn't believe me, but the 12th time I'm believing about my competency. Due to that only, that believeness, that attitudeness, it may help him to clear the examination. That boldness should be there. So it's nothing happening. You should try for clear the examination. That kind of positive spirit it should be developed. And devise your own strategy. So each one having the different mechanism. Some people are studying with group, some people are studying with alone, some people are writing and learn, some people are without taking any notes, they learn. Like that, they have the each types. So don't follow others. That is my always suggestion. You should be unique. You have the unique talent to learn. So that is, you already aware of it. In what way you have to learn, that's you already aware of it. The same mechanism you can adopt. Suppose you are very introvert, generally you may learn by yourself only. Go with yourself. Don't depend on others. Because your own mechanism, your own way of learning strategy may help you to clear the examination. Instead of, don't cope up with others. Right? suppose you are very much open-minded, you want to discuss with someone, you can go and discuss with the people. So that is called strategy. You can design the strategy as like, see here, I'm showing their own images. That guy is taking the books in the three places, two hand and one leg also. So like this, each one having the different way of the learning styles. You can adopt your own learning styles and get the success. Yes, so here the learn, relearn, as well the unlearn. So this, I already emphasized the things. You have to learn first, then after that, you have to understand which are the content area you wrongly understood the content. That area, you can throw it and you can relearn one thing. That's called learn, unlearn, and relearn. And finally, I come, finish my presentation with one small, some of the quotes, accident time. So why I'm showing this sense in the sense, for preparation of native cyclic paint, because you should be spend much time, you should spend the much time, you have to prepare it. But only the things, if you accept the pain, damn sure your life should be fruitful. The future will be fruitful. Why I'm emphasizing here, suppose you have the 10 units of the first paper and second paper, same like, see, all this, this is like a net computer. So all the papers are going to write the examinations. Just for example, I'm telling. So they wait, each one's carrying, no? That is called the unit-wise, the workload. So you have to prepare a lot. So here, all the visions, those who are getting the success of the net, all are carrying the same weight, all are carrying the same weight. So once you're carrying the same weight, they can move it from one place to second place. They are trying to reach the designation to clear the net examination. But some of the people, see, you can focus on the green color guy. So the green color guy in the fourth, he's standing now. What is thinking in the first stage? Thinking that, sir, really, I'm fed up with studying the 10 units. Instead of that, I can remove one unit. I'm not considering 4 units. So I'm not considering the one unit. I can consider only the 9 units. So the 9 unit only me helping to get that success. Like that he planned. That is what he did. He's cut the some of the portion, some of the weight load, some of the portion of his workload, or the studying workload, and he cut something. And finally, he took the same weight, but now less his weight. The weight is less because he already cut some of the portions. So he moves towards the destination. So then when he go also see what he's doing, he's singing the song. Now he's singing the song. With the singing the song, he lead further. Once he lead further, even he's having some kind of dilemma that still I feel some weight because I want to learn 9 units now. So it's better I can cut one more unit or two more units. Like that he planned. He cut some more weight. He cut some more weight, the weight he want to carry. Therefore, finally, he carried with the 8 units or 7 units. So he carried only few units. It means that he carrying only the limited pain. He don't like to get the all the pain. That's why he limited his pain. Once he limited his pain, he walked towards the destinations. But he's a lead very fastly. Finally, what did happen? See, finally, what did happen? He want to reach the next destination, is the next area. But he's not able to move forward. But what about the others? What the others doing? So what the others doing? No. So what the weight they carry previously, that the weights they have the pain on. So when the weight they're carrying, this kind of pain which they carry before that, they can keep it the weight, the pain as a path now. So now they're converting the pain as a path to reach the destinations. Similarly, whenever you cut any unit in the net examinations, it won't be helpful for you. Kindly read all the paper, all the units, and then prepare. And that's why I told you, you can go with some kind of SWOT analysis, which is strength, which is weakness. You can concentrate the weakness area and it can work a lot. So there's a two mode. One is called learning and revision. It should be go synchronous mode in a cycle mode. So, but he's not able to move the next level because he cut the pain. So you don't like to go with much pain. Due to that, he's not able to reach that final destinations. I'm always suggest to get more pain. So if you are getting the more pain, damn sure that pain may help you to lead further. So that is why I put the term access the pain, future will be fruitful. So don't avoid the pain. So in the life also, we are having a lot of problems, issues, but we should face the problems in a confident manner. So don't feel the work you are doing is a pain, because there will be always a reason for the pain or work. So face the pain for the pain you face, there will be definitely happiness ahead. And finally, I mean, even if you pray to the God, some people are pray the God like this only. So please, God, don't give the problem to me. Instead of that, don't ask like this. Instead of that, you can ask the God to give the strength to face this problem, because it's only mold you. When you face the problems, only it's molding the proper personality. So don't ask for a lighter load, but pray God to be stronger back. So that's me. That is called positive spirit. So you are ready to accept the pain, but parallelly you are asking the God to increase my strength to cope up or to face that any kind of difficulties. That is much important. And see, and come back the final mantras. For success, the mantras, for successing the mantras of the UCNET, you have to go with this 6 mantras. One is called sound planning and preparation, because the planning is much important. If you're not planned well, it's equal to you are planning for the failure. Because you are not ready for planning, it's equal to the you are ready to face the failures. Okay, that's, you should be understood that. Then it should be committed. So once you fix the time, some time management or anything, you should be committed, you can do the work. And you can show your enthusiasm always in each and every minute while learning. And the time management is much important. So please divide the work and learn it one by one. Remain healthy. So because this COVID period, you should be healthy. Then only you can attend the examinations and be make the people happy. So main important things, keep your healthy. So concentrate on your healthy body. Then visualize success. That is called vision. Always think about the positive. So don't think that, this time I failed. So next time I'm trying. So don't get that kind of negative thoughts. You can try it. So you can believe that I'm able to try. I hope there is a chance I may clear the dental exam. That kind of positive spirit you might get from where you are. So that positive pictures leads you further to get the success. And I'm going to summarize my presentation with the 4 important quotes. This is a quote said by the Benjamin Franklin said, by failing to prepare. So please kindly see the term, by failing to prepare. Suppose if you are not preparing, if you have failed to prepare, it's equal to, it means that you are ready to preparing to fail. So you are going to face the fail. Due to that only you are failing to prepare. So the term is very much attractive. That's why I'm showing you. So therefore the proper planning is important. By failing to prepare is equal to, or you are thinking that you are planning for the, are you preparing for the fail. And the next thing, your visions. I'm always telling that can-do attitude, positive attitude. Success starts with the vision. So kindly take a positive idea or positive thoughts or positive attitude. That positive attitudes may help you to get the success in the particular field. See, there is a small flower. It comes to in the land. So this land, everything's to be mud and it's closed with the leaves under. Even though the small flower, it's come out from this place. So because the flowers have some kind of vision to see the sunlight, to see the atmosphere. Due to that vision only, it's blooming now. So the same spirit I'm expecting to all of you. Then one more quote for you. The success of the failure is not because of the capabilities. You have a lot of capabilities, but how, which is things may help you to get the success or failure? It depends on the attitude. It's not a capabilities. Even if you have the good capability, even I trust a lot of people. Even I've seen the lot of people in the B.Ed. colleges or the private colleges, they are very much competent to me compared to me. I'm telling openly, even the B.Ed. colleges of the Tamil Nadu, lot of people are very competent in the private colleges. Private colleges people, they have very good capacities. They know how to deal with people, they know how to teach the content in very colloquial manner, in very resourceful manner. But the problem, most of the people I'm crossing, they have not had much attitude. Like whenever they think about that, so for getting the job, you have to give them money. Either they having the wrong notions. Due to that, they cannot move forward. So I request to all, instead of your capabilities, even we need your capabilities, but we must having much the mental attitude, like a positive attitude. Because what you think, that is why it's not told. So I am always thinking to help others. That attitude, it may helping me to reach the best person. That is my belief. So I believe that because I am not giving any kind of wrong things to anyone. So that things may help me to reach my this particular person. Like that I am thinking. So always think positive. Whenever someone's criticizing about any other people, don't take their minds. You can think about the particular people in the good things only. So always think the people in a positive aspects. Your mental attitudes, it's better than it should be compared to your mental capabilities. Your attitude should be superior. So be positive in that. Then finally, you should be always smart. how it should be smart. So all the learners, all the teachers should be smart. So whenever you do the work, it should be a smart work. What is a smart work? The work should be specific. What is a specific? You can success in the NET examinations. And how you can measurable? If you work hard, in the final moment, you are getting the highest mark. From this, you are getting the success as a measurable. Then achievable. So what is the achievable? Finally, you are getting the rank card or JRF or NET holder. Achievable. And even suppose this time you are failure, no problem. You can go with some kind of attempt. That is called SWOT analysis. You can do what is the mistakes you did this examination. So how we can resolve these issues in the next time. You can do the research based. And it should time bound. Don't enrich these activity for 5 years or 6 years. You have to fix the time limit. Within a 2 attempt or within a 1 attempt, I can clear the next examination. Like that, you can specify these areas. Specific, measurable, achievable, research based, and the time based. If you go and lead with this, damn sure, you may get these the proper output from your end. So all the best for the all the NET aspirants. Then next time when you're going to write the examination, I don't know when they're going to write the examination. Hopefully the tips may help you. Just I'm sharing the entire links to all of you. And this is my personal website. This is some people are asking the books also. What I'm going to do, I'm just sharing my web address to all of you. There you might find the entire resource material. I'm sharing this 1 minute. I'm just sharing this link to all of you. So from this, you might find the entire materials, even the Usenet book. Suppose you like to see some of the Usenet materials also, you can go with this. I'm sharing that in our chat box. Please kindly copy this link and keep it in somewhere. Keep it somewhere because once you miss it, you cannot get it. Suppose if you click this link, no, it leads the next page. It leads the next page. Please kindly see. Just I'm going to explain the material which of the things is available here. So this is the PPT materials, particularly for the education people. Unit 6, Unit 8 materials are available. And suppose you like to find the old question paper with answers. This is for the paper 1, 2004 to 2016. Answer key along with the post question paper. This is for the paper 2, this is for the paper 3. So all the materials available. Suppose you like to go with paper 1, if you click here, you may find out the PDF file, even you can download it. So entire papers with answers available, paper 1. Suppose your blanks should be, so it's having more than 300 pages. So it's having 300 pages. Suppose you have blanks to this education, you can go in second and third paper because now the third paper is not there. Even though in the 2016, there's a third paper is the objective mode up to 2015, that paper is available. Suppose you like to get the lot of books because some of the participants, they're asking the books. That's why I'm putting a lot of e-books here. Suppose you like to get the e-books of the paper one, I'm adding the 4 books, Narayanan, Red Eye Publisher, Pearson, Chris Manu, and this book is very much KV Madan. No, it is a very wonderful book. Most of the people suggest this book only, KVS Madan. So if you click it here, you can find out the material as well as the previous question paper, answer script. They can analyze a lot of things here. So this is a very good book. Most of the people are suggesting this book only. This is a Pearson publisher also. And you may get the entire unit. And it is public. You can get the question paper up to 2018. And all the materials they're discussing with unit wise. Please kindly see, he's a man, and this ebook is available in my portal. Kindly download it. So here are all the question paper. Then he given the tips. He already given some other tips. You can follow the tips also. Then if you go with the unit one, so he's giving the brief introduction about the topic. Very clearly. So if you learn the things, damn sure it may helping you a lot because he covered the entire A to Z of the entire content here. After covering all the syllabus, he can give some kind of question as a model. So this book is very much essential. So I'm strongly recommend to go with this third book. That's called Pearson. Otherwise, you can go with other books. And even if you go with the second paper, I recommend to go with the second paper also. I'm added some of the solid question paper, a second paper also. And this is here MOOC test examinations, answer script. Suppose you like to go with, I'm preparing more nearly 200 questions now, 196 today, 194 I think so. For each questions, if you click someone's, you know, automatically you are getting the question as well as the answer. like as a mock answers, it's available here. You can verify it from here, because each day you may get the 10 questions. Like this, I'm uploaded. And similarly, if you go to the next page, if you go with the next page, use important net links. Please kindly, if you go to the next page, I'm giving you all the links. Suppose you like to get the UGC net old syllabus, you can click here. Previous year question paper of UGC, you can click here. Old website, if you want to reach, you can go here. UGC net new website, if you click here, you can go to the new web page of the UGC net. So it gives the hiatuses of the UGC net. And if you like to go with the bulletin, the recent bulletin of the UGCNet, if you click here, you can find out the recent bulletins, books of the UGCNet examinations. So everything's available with a single link. Suppose you like to go with the mock test, you want to attempt this mock test, you can click here, the second link. You can find out the plenty of mock tests. It's only the attempt, like practicing, I'm giving nearly 196 questions are there. Suppose today you are attending the question, if you click here, it asks your name only. You can give your name and you can attend the examination. So very simple manner only I constructed. So very user-friendly tool. You can give the answer. For example, I'm giving the name as a Surya. And click start. Automatically, it asks to the your name. So I'm giving, say, okay. Then click start. So there is a, yeah, so it's better. There is an issue in this. Yeah, I'm on to update. So apparently, if you give the other question paper here, there is a 100 question in the Google form. This is a question for the Tesmos. So you can explore the questions from here itself. So I think this is the student login, the admission login. So hopefully I think I covered the entire thing. I give some of the inputs related how to get the success in the UGCNet examinations. I'm coming back to the last stage of my presentations, that is called acknowledgement. I want to share that sincere thanks to the two important things. One is called mission-based thanks, as well as the human-based thanks. First of all, I thanks to the Pixabay and Unsplash website. From this only, I found a lot of good images. From this, I construct my PPT. And thanks to Google search to find out the tips and the tricks to success of the UGCNet examination. Thanks to the PPT, PowerPoint. From this, only I'm sharing my views. And thanks to Google Meet. So really sorry for that, because due to limitation of the Google, I can add only the 100 people. Even in between, also a lot of people are admitting. So even some people are skipped in between. So now the final is 95. So even some people still they are asking to admit. So you cannot be accommodate all the people. Then I'm sharing my thanks to the human base, particularly the entire TNTU, particularly the civil service, the coaching center, especially the professor N. Ramakrishnan sir, because I'm regularly observing the past 1 year, he's very active. Even if he was the syndicate member, he's having a lot of commitment. Even though in his busy schedule, he's working hard. And I'm regularly watching his post through the Facebook and his WhatsApp status. So at least per month, he's organized nearly every week there is a Q's program. Every week he organizes kind of programs like this. Every week, I think there is more than 10 programs he organizing from his end. So it's not easy, because the professor grade, the people, they like to escape from this kind of activity. But even he's reached the professor, but he's working like anything. So it's not at all possible for the other professors, the senior professors. So in this juncture, I'm sharing some thanks to the Ramakrishnan sir and the other faculty members of this department. And thanks to the committee member, particularly the Prashita and other scholars, because they only contact me and they make the things a very easy manner, and she disseminating the invitation to all of us. Thanks to Prashita and other team members of this program, and thanks to my friends, those who are attending the programs. I think some of the people I'm little familiar with these people. Really sorry, I'm not able to pinpoint the names of the people. Still, I'm getting a lot of messages, as well as that admitting message. That's why I'm not able to read the message, particularly the Purushottaman sir and some other people I'm familiar with them. So in the juncture, I'm sharing the thanks to all the people, those attending here. And all the best to all the participants to get the positive end, positive results from your end while attending the examination. Thank you all. If you have any questions, kindly ask me now.
சார், ஃபர்ஸ்ட் பேப்பர் மார்க் எவ்வளோ சார் வாங்கினா பாஸ் பண்ண முடியும்? ஃபர்ஸ்ட் பேப்பர் அண்ட் செகண்ட் பேப்பர் மார்க் காம்பினேஷன்.
ஆமாம், ஆக்சுவலி இந்த கேஸ் ஆஃப் ஃபர்ஸ்ட் பேப்பர் அண்ட் செகண்ட் பேப்பர் த பர்சன்டேஜ் 40%, ரைட்? 40%. பட் இந்த கேஸ் ஆஃப் தி ஓபிசி அஸ்வல் தி எஸ்சி எஸ்டி 35% ஜெனர், ரைட்? But the problem is not percentage. Passing is not a problem here. Because each one can pass. Even you can get the 40% in first paper, 40% second paper. It's not helping for the pass mark. Because how they're doing this is quite a relative grade. The system is a relative grade. How you can do, suppose there is 100 students, they're writing the examination on particular paper in the sense, the first is 6%. That's called only 6% of people only, they may get the pass. So it is like a relative grade. Even the 100 people are writing the examination, those are getting the highest mark of the first 6 ranking. That people only treated as a pass mark. It got clear. Even if you are getting the pass mark in the first paper and second paper also, it's not helping you. You should be competent. You should be get the first 6% of the mark, the entire people, entire people, those are attempt the examination. Suppose 1,000 people are writing the examination for the education paper, 60 people may pass, 60 people only pass. You got clear. Even you are getting the pass mark in this first paper, second paper also, it may not be helping you. So you may get the highest mark. That's why I told, always gain the first paper is the great, good mark. So it may help you to get the success in the entire research.
Yeah,
right?
Sir. Thank you so much.
So any other questions?
Any other questions from participants? Participants? Any other queries?
Okay, since there is no question, I thank profusely Dr. Tyagu for having spent spared his time and sharing his valuable notes regarding preparation for UGC NET examination, sharing his own experiences, and also motivating students to appear for this examination. And he has given a lot of inputs regarding the various websites with regard to preparation. And also, especially this, that path, you know, or the paper sala and other net applications apps. So it will be useful for our students. And since many of them are not able to join, they are asking me to have one more session like this. So our center is always welcoming Dr. Tyagu. Whenever he finds time, he can come in, and you can use this platform to share his knowledge with the audience, because audience from all the states, I think so, mostly from our southern states, Kerala, Karnataka, Tamil Nadu, Andhra, people are here, and they are expecting you to present more and more. We are very happy. We are ready to give slot to you any time that you wish to do any program with us. We always welcome you, always extend a warm welcome to you. And we are always thankful to you for having spent your valuable time with all the audiences here. We highly regard you. Thank you so much. We pray to God to give more and more blessings on you. Thank you so much, Dr. Tyagu. Now, Prasita will follow me in giving word of thanks. Before that, I would like to say my team members, especially Mangalkasi College of Education Principal, Dr. R.K. Prasila, Divya, Revadi, Jamuna, and Revadi, Jamuna, Mugeshwari, Mutrani, Umarani, and all these team members. With these team members only, I am managing all these things. Without them, I couldn't do Prasida, Gilbertrani, and Sarada. All these people are helping me. My beloved scholar, Damodaran, is doing all the things. All my scholars are doing these works, and I am thankful to you. I'm doing this with their help, and it is also a helping tool for them. They can also utilize this to reach greater heights. So with this, I wind up my speech. Once again, finally, I would like to thank Dr. Tyagu.
Thank you,
sir. It is my pleasure now to propose the vote of thanks in this national level seminar on Learn, Relearn and Unlearn UGC NET exam orientation, organized by the Center for Civil Services and TNPSC Coaching, Tamil Nadu Teachers Education University, Chennai. I would like to thank our resource person, Dr. K. Tyagu, Assistant Professor, Department of Education, Central University of Kerala, who has spared his most precious time for us in knowledge sharing. Thank you so much, sir. There is always a word that pictures talk more than words, and it has been proved from your presentation. The way you talk with us and convey the message to the pictures was really wonderful. Thank you very much, sir. My sincere thanks to Dr. N. Ramakrishnan, Member Syndicate, Professor and Head, Department of Educational Technology, and coordinator of Center for Civil Services and TNPSC Coaching TNTEU for organizing valuable and informative sessions like this. Thank you so much, sir. I thank all my team members who are always at our support. Without my team, I would not be able to do this much, do this better. Thank you, team members. Next, I would like to sincerely thank the participants from various colleges who have joined with us today. Thank you, participants. Once again, I would like to sincerely thank each and everyone present here. Thank you all, and thank you very much. I wish we would all meet in more sessions like this. Thank you so much.
Thank you. Thank you.